In this video, we'll take a look at how to start animating the sprites we create in Piskel. We'll take this potion and show it being consumed over 1 second. So far, we've created a potion sprite, and we split the bottle and the potion onto two separate layers. But the potion still only has one frame. Let's take a look at how to add some frames, and then we'll do some basic animation on the potion. A frame is an image in a series of images, where each image is displayed for a set period of time. These frames are displayed in sequence, which creates the animation. You can see all of the frames created for this sprite on the left side of the screen here. You can only see the bottle layer right now, but if I select the potion layer, the frame will show that layer as a preview. Only the currently selected layer is shown in the frame preview. To add a new frame to the project, click on Add New Frame. This adds a new blank frame at the end of the timeline after all other frames. If you click on the lower left corner of a frame and drag it, you can reorder the frames. If you click on the top right corner on the trash can, you can delete a frame. And if you make a mistake, you can press Ctrl-Z to undo. Last, if you click on the icon in the bottom right corner of the frame, you can duplicate that frame. With the second frame selected, press E to select the eraser tool. I'll erase the entire top line and some of the line below it. Then I'll duplicate the second frame, and we can erase a little more. Duplicate the third frame, and erase. I want this animation to consist of 6 frames of the potion being consumed, so I'll duplicate the fourth frame, and erase. And finally the fifth frame, and just leave a little bit of potion at the bottom. Duplicate the sixth frame, and erase the last bit of potion. One of the best features of Piskel is the live preview of animations you create. The live preview can be seen in this window here. Right now, we don't see a preview of the animation because I have the frame rate set to 0. You can see the current frame rate here, next to FPS. FPS stands for frames per second. The frame rate is the number of frames displayed per second. If I set the frame rate to 1, then the animation will advance by 1 frame per second. We have 6 frames, so this animation would take 6 seconds to complete. I want this animation to last for 1 second total, but I want the potion to be consumed in half a second, and the bottle to sit empty for half a second. I'll set the frame rate to 12, so 12 frames in 1 second. Then I'll duplicate the 7th frame 5 times, to give us 12 frames total. On the live preview, if you click 1x, you can toggle between the fully zoomed in sprite or the actual size. And if you click this arrow icon, it opens the preview into a pop-up window. You can resize the window, and the sprite is resized accordingly. That's all there is to animating a sprite in Piskel. Just add or duplicate frames, alter the sprite, or redraw it completely to step forward in the timeline. Make sure to utilize Piskel's live preview so you can see how the animation looks as you're creating it. You'll be able to see if a frame looks awkward and needs adjustment. Once you're finished creating frames, make sure to set the frame rate to get the correct speed for your animation. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Comment, like, and share this video, and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.